In addition to the gold, silver, and precious stones, there are five crowns that will be given out at the judgment seat of Christ, if the Lord so chooses. The first crown is the incorruptible crown, which is found in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verses 24 to 27. Those verses say this, "Know ye not that they which run in a race run all, but one receiveth the prize? So run that ye may obtain. And every man that striveth for the mastery is temperate in all things. Now, they do it to obtain a corruptible crown, but we an incorruptible. I therefore so run not as uncertainly, so fight I not as one that beateth the air, but I keep under my body and bring it into subjection, lest that by any means, when I have preached to others, I myself should be a castaway." This crown is given to the men who keep themselves physically fit through temperance. You say, now what's temperance? Well, temperance is basically self-control and self-denial. Through temperance, a saint is always able to do any task that God requires of him. He must apply himself diligently to every task as a living sacrifice. In temperance, he must deny himself. Like Matthew chapter 16, verses 24 and 25 say, "Then said Jesus unto his disciples, If any man will come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whosoever will save his life shall lose it, and whosoever will lose his life for my sake shall find it." In addition to that, he must live by the Spirit. In Romans chapter 8, we have three verses, verse 1, verse 13, and verse 14, that say these things. "There is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. For if you live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. For as many as are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God." So that's the first crown. The second crown is the crown of rejoicing, which is found in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 and verse 19. That verse says, "For what is our hope, or joy, or crown of rejoicing? Are not even ye in the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ at his coming?" You know what this is? This crown is the soul winner's crown. You get this one for leading souls to Jesus Christ. Each new soul that you win to Christ adds a stone to this crown. It's called the crown of rejoicing because salvation brings joy to the new convert. It brings joy to the person who led him to Jesus Christ, and it brings joy to those who are in heaven. In Luke chapter 15, we have two verses, verse 7 and verse 10, that say this, "I say unto you that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repenteth more than over 99 just persons which need no repentance. Likewise, I say unto you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner that repenteth." Now, do you want to start causing some joy in heaven and obtain a crown for doing it? Then start leading some souls to Jesus Christ. The third crown is the crown of righteousness, which is found in 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 8. That verse says, "Henceforth there is laid up for me a crown of rejoicing, which the Lord, the righteous judge, shall give me at that day, and not to me only, but unto all them that love his appearing." This crown is obtained by them who love the appearing of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's like Titus chapter 2, verse 13 says, "Looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior, Jesus Christ." This is the crown of righteousness because when you're expecting the Lord's return any day, you live righteously. John said it in 1 John chapter 3 in verses 1 through 3. He said this, "Behold what manner of love the Father hath bestowed upon us, that we should be called the sons of God. Therefore the world knoweth us not, because it knew him not. Beloved, now are we the sons of God, and it doth not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. And every man that hath this hope in him purifieth himself, even as he is pure." For those of us who truly love the Lord Jesus Christ, there will be no greater day following our salvation than the day in which we actually get to see our Savior face to face. The greatest hope a Christian has for solving all of his earthly problems is the return of the Lord Jesus Christ. When the Lord Jesus Christ takes us home to heaven, there is not a problem which you are currently experiencing that will not be solved. That in itself ought to get you looking for the Lord Jesus Christ. The fourth crown is the crown of life, which is found in James chapter 1 and verse 12. Blessed is the man that endureth temptation, for when he is tried, he shall receive the crown of life, which the Lord hath promised to them that love him. Now this crown is given to men who endure temptation. According to Romans chapter 8, verse 13, the way to do this is to mortify the deeds of the body. Listen to the verse. For if we live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if ye through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. This way you will not yield to temptation. It's like you're a dead man. Now, you know what? This crown also shows up in Revelation chapter 2 and verse 10. That verse says this, Fear none of those things which thou shalt suffer. Behold, the devil shall cast some of you into prison, that ye may be tried, and ye shall have tribulation 10 days. But be thou faithful unto death, and I will give thee a crown of life. Well, there it is. It's a martyr's crown given to the tribulation saints who are slain for their faith in Jesus Christ. So you see that this crown is given to men who pay a great price. Your fight against temptation and sin would have to be great in order to match the sacrifice of a man who is a martyr. The fifth crown is the crown of glory, which is found in 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse 4. That passage says, And when the chief shepherd shall appear, ye shall receive a crown of glory that fadeth not away. This crown is primarily a pastor's reward. It's given to men who properly feed their flocks with the Word of God. Look at the context in verses 1 through 3. They say this, The elders which are among you I exhort, who am also an elder, and a witness of the sufferings of Christ, and also a partaker of the glory that shall be revealed. Feed the flock of God which is among you, taking the oversight thereof, not by constraint, but willingly, not for filthy lucre, but of a ready mind. Neither as being lords over God's heritage, but being examples to the flock. So you see, this is a pastor's crown, but perhaps this crown is also available to teachers of the Word of God. Obviously, if a teacher is teaching out of a modern translation and doesn't believe that the King James Bible is the Word of God, he wouldn't be properly feeding the flock, and he wouldn't get this crown. Even men who profess to believe the King James Bible could be teaching with the wrong motive and missed this crown. The Lord is the only one who can make this judgment properly. So, given the opportunity to win some crowns at the judgment seat of Christ, you should get started serving the Lord Jesus Christ in temperance, and in soul winning, and in rejoicing at His coming, and in resisting temptation. And if you are in a position to teach and lead some of God's children, then feed them well. And may God bless you when you do.